Here we are in Stockholm, June 3rd, 2004. Here's the central station, train station, right outside our Sheraton Hotel. Here we are in front of our hotel. That's the City Hall where the Nobel Peace Prize is awarded, and all the ceremonies are there. That's the headquarters for the Stockholm city. Entrance to our hotel. Very nice hotel. We've been here 3 days. Here we are again at City Hall. Evan and I went there yesterday, so Ryan and Jenny are going today. Ryan wasn't feeling well yesterday. Again, this is where the Nobel Peace Prize is awarded. Down the steps and touch the water. Yeah, be careful. Do one more time, Ryan, be careful. Goodbye to Stockholm. We're fixing to board the Crystal Symphony in about an hour. Over there is Old Town. And our Sheraton Hotel.
See in the room?
That's right. I'll be right back. That's when you close it.
Alan, I've got your funds right here.
So we're at the Stockholm port, June 3rd. Departing in about an hour, 6:45 in the evening. You can see a vessel going out. on deck number 9. We're having the fire drill in a few minutes, which is on deck 7, which is where these life raft vessels are. In the distance is the downtown Stockholm area. There we are. So Evan and Ryan have their own cabin about the same size, also with a veranda.
Except the veranda's bigger.
Leaving the port of Stockholm, capital of Sweden. See a ferry coming back from Finland. Thrusters are working, get us out from the pier. Janet and Evan taking some wildlife pictures with the big zoom lens, the 100-400 Canon lens. Boats maneuvering, backing up there. Now about 7 in the evening. Sun won't set until about 10 p.m. tonight. So that's where we were moored, right in there. According to the captain, about 4 hours to get out to the sea. Thank you. Here we see the typical red summer cottage house of the Swedes. Okay, here we are arriving in Helsinki, Finland. About 8 o'clock in the morning, June 5th. Sun rose early today, about 4:30. So we're just coming into the cargo port. This is also where some cruise ships are made. Coming in at her own power, no tugboats. Beautiful weather, about 60 degrees. Another ferry going out here. They're going back to Stockholm.
Orthodox churches are very interesting, so that we will visit the Lutheran church of this tour today. But if you are interested, then in the afternoon you can go there on your own. there are more harbor areas on this side. We call it the North Harbor. During sail ship's time, this was the main harbor. But now it's more for the pleasure boats. Here are old sail ships, but nowadays they are used as pleasure boats. And then there's also the guest harbor. If you decide to come here with your own private yacht, this is the guest harbor here to the right. Oh, that is quite interesting old look. But it has a foreign flag. Is that the French flag? Or is it the Dutch flag?
You walk on. Looking at Helsinki University here. sticky leaves there. Notice.
Alrighty, let's go back to the bus.
Should get one for Eugene.
Is there a ship over here?
No, it's on.
There's another one.
No, it's on down. That's a ferry.
Oh.
Getting ready to depart Helsinki at 5 p.m. heading for St. Petersburg. Thank you. Just a second. It could be dropping off a pilot.
I'll pick up the pilot.
Yeah. Here we are in Russia, St. Petersburg, June 6, 7:30 in the morning. Thank you.
for today?
Questions concerning big bags. So I kindly ask you, if you have a big bag, you take valuables with your money, passports, and the big size bag, please leave it on the bus. It is not allowed, ladies and gentlemen, to take bottles with water inside the museum. So please, if... And it was a solitary, secluded place when the collection was started by Catherine the Great in 1764. As those days, in one of her letters, she wrote that only she and mice could admire the collection. Later on, she allowed the courtiers that tour we make stops where were staterooms, and after French Impressionists, we come to the palace. And then after the Winter Palace, we go to the small Hermitage, which now these days, of course, looks different from what it was in the time of Catherine the Great. But there we go through the beginning of the French collection. We're beginning from the 15th century and then to the 18th century paintings and pieces of applied, to the second floor of the Winter Palace, where we have the collection of French Impression. To the Winter Palace, where we finish with the most beautiful rooms of the Winter Palace, like the Malachite, the concert, and the ballroom. Now on the Neva embankment, we're going the main waterway of the city, the Neva River, so we are very close to the Hermitage Museum, probably 1 minute and a half only, right from the Hermitage we are now, and on our way we are passing on you. Ladies and gentlemen, in case you have long coats or over jackets, then you may leave them on the coach, we are very close to the entrance door. Short jackets, it's okay. You write the Winter Palace. This is where we go. This is where we leave our bus.
And Restrooms, ladies and gentlemen, I recommend. The Russian Tsar Alexander I was put in between
that he commissioned English artist Dorf to make the portraits of the Russian generals. All small size portraits, they're portraits of the Russian generals. Not a single officer. Here you will find more than 300 giant associated with the name of Leonardo da Vinci. And the second name, Madonna Benoit, as it was in the private collection of Benoit family, the Benoit, the first Madonna with the flower. Have a look, and please find that the former owner of the painting was the Duke of Lido of Italy. So it was purchased from his collection and it was given the name of the former owner, Madonna Lita by Leonardo. The first one we have seen, it was made in oils. The second that we're making a stop now, Madonna Lita, it was made in tempera, in mineral colors it was made. So on that painting, of course, you can see how Leonardo elaborated the colors. Bright, but they concentrated on colors and they truly believe that with the help of colors they can create volume. Their names are Rosso and Pantomo, the artists that made Madonnas you can see here. So they diverted, we may say, from the achievements that was made by the artists of high Renaissance. And the trend later on became of the artist Madonna with a child. So when it was purchased in the 19th century, in the time of Alexander II, the painting by Raphael was purchased from Conestabile, and the Italians were absolutely furious with him when he decided to sell that painting to Russia. The gentleman needed money made by Raphael. Those days, Raphael was befriended with the architect of Italian lodges, whose name was Bramante. And he took Bramante, the architect, for the model of beardless Joseph. So the Holy Family of Madonna with beardless Joseph. When the building was opened as the public museum in 1852, the portraits and the well-dressed people were allowed only to look at the collection. Later on, they changed the rules. All well-dressed people were allowed to come and to look at the collection. So this building was the exception because it was as the museum. Another room with the skylight windows in our way, but here when you look at the decoration where the vases and the tables, this is malachite. Malachite that came from the Ural Mountains. We're going to see also the malachite room. The same technique was used for the decoration of the malachite room and for the tabletops and for the vases, like for the lapis lazuli of his paintings, the paintings of his different period. We have in our collection all paintings here, the ones by Rubens. I accentuate notes that highlights of the collection like the Union of Earth and Water that was made by Rubens at the time when Flanders was cut off from the sea, so he would like to remind his people how it was important to get it out into the sea. The descent from the cross, one of the areas where minerals came to the rock. And the place was guarded by Mitchell's corner. And it was dangerous to go there because everyone who came there was stoned by Mitchell's corner. And first, he decided to leave that beautiful cross there. And he raised it for the beautiful cross. one painting here by Claude Monet. We have by Claude Monet garden in Montgeron, pond in Montgeron by Claude Monet. We have also by Claude Monet. By Renoir, we have the Beauty Lady. This is also the work by Renoir. He started to make paintings when he was 13 years old. So the whole collection that we're going to see now on our way, beginning from Renoir's home, it was all made by two Russian people, by Shukin and by Marokis. Could look upon the paintings that he made, that they will be the gems, you know. As they are now here. It's a very long violence. Ladies and gentlemen, in this room where you see cityscapes on your right when you come, works by French artist Vladimir. When you see colorful here, put in the glass case near the window. We have from his blue period the painting from the door, the first part, the ads in our collection. Then from the blue period, the two pieces of the painting, the name of the painting, from the blue period, the half size body of the young gentleman, and the body of Dr. Saleh. This is all from his blue period. For the rest, in this room and in the next one, all his cubistic period, which he experimented from like 4,000
years. Such a wonderful angel.
In the Winter Palace as Rotunda. After restoration, the parquet floor is these days. The room was decorated with the portraits of the members of the Russian royal family. Ladies and gentlemen, now our stop in the most beautifully decorated room of the Winter Palace, the former private premises of Russian Tsarina, the Malachite. Tons of now.